Hello, today I want to tell you about breast cancer. Breast cancer takes second place among all cancers and it takes first place among female population. You see now here is symbol of breast cancer. This is the international symbol of breast cancer. Shortly, I'll remind you anatomy of breast. It's located on the chest wall. It consists of lobules, central ducts, nipple, areola. Here is again about anatomy. You see lymph system of breast, axillary region, subscapular region, subclavicular region, parasternal. Here is again about nipple, areola, and structure of the breast. Now about lymph drainage of the breasts. Most of lymph vessels are drained into the axillary subscapulary nodes, supraclavicular or infraclavicular lymph nodes, and sometimes in case of inner location of tumors, maybe internal mammary lymph nodes. Again, I'll show you structure of lymph nodes and lymph vessels of the breast, axillary zone, infraclavicular, supraclavicular, and internal mammary lymph nodes or parasternal. Here, some words about benign lesions of the breast. First of all, it's fiber adenoma. Fiber adenoma, this is a benign tumor, painless, with smooth borders, usually in young females, very, very frequent, and it grows slowly, but sometimes it may convert to malignant tumors, but not to cancer, to sarcoma. Cystic breast changes very, very often, and it's one of manifestations of diffuse mastopathy, fibrous cystic disease of all the breast tissue. It can lead to cancer. Breast cancer development. It can develop from epithelium of inner lining of milk ducts or of the lobules. That's why it may be ductal carcinoma or lobular carcinoma. Here is three types of breast cancer. Ductal carcinoma, inflammatory breast cancer, separate type of breast cancer, and lobular carcinoma. Ductal carcinoma may be invasive and non-invasive DCIS, also lobular carcinoma may be also invasive lobular carcinoma or lobular carcinoma in situ, LCIS, and separately inflammational breast cancer, IBC. About inflammational breast cancer, it's very uncommon, I think less even than 1%. This is invasive breast cancer, no lump or tumor. This is diffuse tumor from the beginning. And of course, it looks like inflammation of the breast. That's why inflammation of breast cancer makes the skin of the breast look red and feel warm, all signs of inflammation. It also may make the skin look thick and the breast may get bigger, hard, tender, or itchy. This is view of inflammatory breast cancer. You see, it looks like mastitis of the breast. It simulates mastitis of the breast and it may be mistakes. And here is some signs of this tumor, inverted nipple due to very severe edema of the breast, pudor ranch also due to edema of the skin, etc. This is another types of inflammatory breast cancer. You see maybe practically local inflammational forms and diffuse all the breast. Ductal carcinoma in situ, DCIS, non-invasive. It is starting from milk ducts, epithelium of milk ducts, and may become invasive later. And here is how it grows. You see, it starts in ducts and from the beginning, it doesn't spread through the lumen basement membrane of the ducts, always in the ducts. And this is ductal carcinoma in situ, T0 form. Invasive ductal carcinoma, most common breast cancer. It starts from the ducts and then it grows and then may give metastasis to lymph nodes or distant metastasis. Lobar carcinoma in situ, also non-invasive, starts in lobules and also may become invasive. Also T04, and here is, you see, it starts in epithelium of lobules. And here is without invasion of membranes of these lobules. Here is, this is lobular non-invasive form, LCIS. Invasive lobular carcinoma also forms in lobules, but spread outside the basement membrane, of course, and can spread to the lymph nodes or to give distant metastasis. Some words about etiology of breast cancer. And first of all, of course, this is gender, more prevalent in women, but it can meet in males also, in 150 times, of course, less, but it can meet. Age, chance of breast cancer occurrence, of course, more with age. After 50, it's very, very high in females. About genetic risk factors. Maybe you know, maybe you don't know about BRCA mutation. BRCA mutation, maybe one or two, it can meet in women. And you see here is lifetime breast cancer risk in BRCA mutation population. You see in five times more than in normal population without mutation. And median age of breast cancer onset, you see very early. If normally in without mutation after 60, here is 40. Familial history. Breast cancer in close relatives. You know what is this close relative I told you before. This is one step in every side. Personal history of breast cancer. Of course, in women which had breast cancer previously, maybe breast cancer of another breast, and in 20 times higher risk of another breast cancer, development. Race, ethnic background. Overall, white women are slightly more likely to get breast cancer than African American, but in African American, they are more likely to die of breast cancer because they have more aggressive forms more frequently. Asian, Hispanic, and Native American women, less risk of breast cancer occurrence. Dense breast tissue. Of course, dense breast tissue, and non-dense breast tissue. Here is what it means. Dense breast tissue, it means a lot of glandular tissue. Of course, if a lot of glandular tissue, higher risk of breast cancer development. Dense breast tissue correlates with risk of breast cancer. Certain benign breast problems, for example, diffuse or local or even local mastopathy, maybe, of course, base of development of breast cancer. Menstrual period, early menses or late menopause. Breast radiation early in life. Other risk factors, not having children. Or late children, certain kinds of birth control, hormone therapy after menopause, not breastfeeding, alcohol, overweight. Also very harmful habit, also tobacco smoke may lead to higher risk of breast cancer development, night work due to a lot of estrogens. Prevention, alcohol consumption, physical exercises, diet, postmenopausal hormonal treatment, body weight control, breast cancer screening, and breastfeeding. Signs of breast cancer. First of all, for nodal forms of breast cancer, this is a lump in the breast. Pain in the armpits or breasts that does not seem to be related to the woman's menstrual period. First time found. Pitting or redness of the skin of the breast. So sometimes it may be the skin of or pure orange. Rash around or on one of the nipples. A swelling in one of the armpits. an area of thickened tissue in a breast. Sometimes discharges from the nipple and even with blood. Nipple may become sunken or inverted due to edema. Size or the shape of the breast may change. Nipple skin or breast skin may have started to peel, scale or flake. Here is changes of the nipple. Sometimes patients can feel pain, maybe redness, scaliness, itching, skin thickening, inward nipple, you see here is, and discharges from the nipple. Here is signs of breast cancer, clinical signs. During exam, change in size or shape of the breast, redness or rash of the skin, discharges from the nipple, swelling in your armpit, a lump or thickening that feel different from the rest of the breast tissue, first time found, first of all. Change in skin texture, such as puckering or dimpling, or constant pain in your breast or your armpit, not before menses, maybe, first of all. Diagnostics of breast cancer. Clinical examination, this is breast exam. Imaging tests, mammograms, breast ultrasound, breast MRI, and some types of biopsies. Breast exams can be clinical by doctor or breast self-exam. Clinical breast exam, first of all, before. After 40, women need to undergo clinical breast exam by doctor every year. Self-exam is an option, but it's very, women need to do it after 20. My opinion, every 3 months. Any changes should be reported to doctor, and then of course clinical breast exam need to be examined and breast self-exam conducted standing or reclining. Here is standing with fingertips all close together, gently probe, and directions you see in every 3 directions. Here is, but better all together. Here is reclining, all the same. Mammograms. This is X-ray of the breast. Very small amount of the radiation. Maybe screening and diagnostical. How it doing? Technologist will position breast for the test. And between 2 plates, pressure lasts only a few seconds. During this time, we take X-ray, and there are 2 projections for every breast, and it takes around approximately about 20 minutes. Here is schematically how it's doing. And there are 3 examples of breast imaging. First is normal mammogram. You see here is structure of the breast, breast ducts, vessels, breast tissue, nipple, even chest wall. On the second, you see benign cyst of the breast with smooth borders and cystic. Here is 3rd example is cancer. Very, very bright, without precise borders, invasive, with invasion to adjacent structures and even infiltration of adjacent structures, you see. Breast ultrasound used very widely. It used sound waves to outline the part of the body, and sound waves echoes are picked up by a computer, of course, to create a picture. And used to investigate areas of concerns found by a mammogram. And usually we use ultrasound for better, first of all, for axillary regions to reveal or not reveal enlarged lymph nodes, and for guided biopsies under the control of CT, FNA or core needle biopsies under the control of ultrasound, because this is real-time examination, very helpful. Here is how it's doing. Also, magnetic resonance imaging. Use magnets, radio waves, of course, cross-sectional images of the body and of the breast, of course. The MRI scans can take a long time, 25 minutes approximately. Also used if you areas of concern found on the mammograms. And here is how patient is lying in MRI. How it doing? Spatial magnet for breasts. And here is magnetic resonance imaging of normal breast. You see it's maybe best imaging of the breast. You can clearly see vessels, even with atherosclerosis, ducts, breast tissue, fat tissue, all separately. You see here that it's very, very high level imaging of the breast. Best choice, I think. Types of breast biopsy: fine needle aspiration biopsy, core needle biopsy, vacuum assisted biopsies, surgical or open biopsy, and lymph node biopsy. Fine needle aspiration, of course, painless, less invasive than all others. Very fine needle for this. Extract fluid from the lump or some cells, guided by ultrasound, I told you. Simple, but is not all cases accurate, because we take only some cells, tumor cells or maybe another cells, because we cannot tell exactly what did we take. We took cells, but what cells? These are cells, this is material for cytological diagnostics. That's why, of course, not accurate in all cases. It's doing under the control of ultrasound usually. Here is core needle biopsy. You see needle is larger than a fine needle biopsy, removes more tissue, even column of tissue. We send it to not cytological, to histological and immunohistochemical examinations. And of course, clearer results, because we have histological examination. This is column of tissue and of tumor. That's why a lot of questions we answer. Here is how we're doing it. Core needle biopsy, and here is under the control of ultrasound, spatial device. Vacuum assisted biopsies, done with systems such as ATTACC, guided by MRI. First, we cut the skin, and hollow probe is put through this cut into the breast tissue, and then part of this of tumor is sucked out. Here is how it's doing with help of MRI. Here is surgical open biopsy. First of all, local anesthesia of the skin and underlying tissues. We make an incision and we remove part of tumor. We make an incisional biopsy of a superficial part of tumor for histological and immunohistochemical examination. Here is how it's doing, incision and then removal of part of tumor. Lymph node biopsy. What do we do? We do aspirations of lymph nodes, fine needle or core needle biopsy, or removal of lymph nodes. We call it open biopsy, open surgical biopsy of lymph node. Here is some words, how it's doing. We do it by ordinary biopsy without any radioactive or substance or dye, or we remove only lymph node. Or sometimes we need to estimate about sentinel lymph nodes, some words about it. This is first guard of the breast. First, it may be affected by malignant cells, and first may be N positive. That's why we can estimate a fraction of all regional lymph nodes by the estimation of affection of first guard. First guard, this is sentinel lymph nodes. It is located paramammally, you see here, And how can we find this sentinel lymph node? We inject dye or radioactive substance around tumor, and it evacuates through lymph vessels, first of all, to the guard lymph node. It first is colored by dye, or it first will be radioactive. We find it, we cut, and we remove it. And we can send it to histological examination to estimate, is it affected or not? And here is biopsy of sentinel lymph node schematically. Examination of breast tissues, histological examination, first of all. We need to determine, is it malignant or benign, morphological type of tumor, invasive or non-invasive disc cancer, or maybe in carcinoma in situ, size of tumor. Of course, are lymph nodes affected or not? And or on the base of this and all others, which I'll tell later, we'll think about treatment. Breast cancer grade, G letter. Also, this is answer of histological examination. Hormone receptor, and after all of this, we speak about now, we speak about immunohistochemical examination, another one. And here is, we need to determine hormone receptor status for breast, for all cases, abbreviation ERPR. HER2-new status, this is spatial marker of breast cancer, tyrosine kinase receptor, one of tyrosine kinase receptors, which is specific for breast cancer also, for a lot of cancer, but for breast cancer also. Ki67 status, this is proliferation marker. Also, we need it for thinking about treatment. About grade G, it may vary from 0 to 3. It's from general oncology, I repeat. A lower grade number means a slower growing cancer. Of course, higher grade, a faster growing cancer. Effect of treatment depends of this grade, and that's why grade helps predict the outcome of disease. Hormone receptor status. Hormone receptor status, these are proteins on the surface. Hormone receptors, proteins on the surface of tumor cells. They can bind to hormones, estrogen and progestine, because estrogen and progesterone hormones fuel breast cancer growth, and connection between them can fuel growth of the tumor. Brain cancer are tested for hormone receptors. If tumor doesn't have them, we call estrogen receptor negative. For example, if tumor have receptors of estrogen, we call it estrogen receptor positive, ER plus. About 2/3 tumors have at least one of these receptors. HER2-new status. Tumor with increased level of HER2-new status, this is separate group of patients. We call them HER2-new positive patients, and they need very special treatment. We call it targeted therapy by HER2-new inhibitors before all the treatment to decrease tumor. Combination of these molecular subtypes of breast cancer, maybe four most frequent combinations, and we call them luminal A and luminal B types. These are receptor positive types. What difference? Luminal A need to be receptor estrogen positive, progesterone positive or negative, HER2-new negative for both, but Ki67 less than 14%. Luminal B, what difference is? Progesterone receptors may be negative, or Ki67 need to be 15 and more persons. HER2-new, of course, HER2-new positive, and triple negative breast cancer, maybe worst prognosis form with worst outcome. It has negative estrogen, progestin receptors, HER2-new negative, and Ki67, usually more than 14%. How can we detect distant metastasis? For chest X-ray for the lungs. osteoscintigraphy for the bones with technetium-99m, CT scan for all the organs in the chest, abdomen and pelvis, MRI for central nervous system metastasis, and ultrasound for special special indication for some organs. Staging of breast cancer, of course, TNM staging of breast cancer. Now we have 8th edition of TNM classification. T, this is primary tumor, N, regional lymph nodes, M, distant metastasis. What do we have? Tumor size. T. T depends on the size of the tumor. You see T1 less than 2 centimeters, T2 between 2 and 5, T3 more than 5 centimeters, and T4 extension to chest wall, skin or ulceration, or all diffuse forms. N. N1 from 1 till 3, and 2 from 4 till 9, and then 3 more than 9. Metastasis, presence or absence, all very simple. Staging of breast cancer. Don't mix stages with T grades. Of course, these are different terms. Staging of breast cancer. Stage 0, all non-invasive forms. All non-invasive forms. Stage 1, less than 2 centimeters without affection of regional lymph nodes. And now stage 2A, less than 2 centimeters, but maybe lymph nodes affected. Stage 2B, tumor from 2 till 5 centimeters and split to lymph nodes or more than 5 centimeters. You see a lot of combinations. Stage 3. Greater than 5 centimeters, 3A, and spread to lymph nodes, forming clumps, or more than 5 centimeters, and spread to lymph nodes without forming clumps. Stage 3B, spreading to the skin and maybe to chest wall, swelling of the breast. Stage 3C, any size and spreading to lymph nodes, skin and chest wall. Stage 3D, oh, and enough. Stage 4, metastasized. And now you see and you know that the survival of patient depends on their stage. At stage 0 survival, practically all patients live more than 5 years, and also in first stage. At second stage, 93%, very high. Third stage, even third stage in breast cancer, 72. And fourth stage, of course, with distant metastasis, not so a lot, but 22%. And you see overall survival in case of breast cancer, not so bad, as I told you, in case due to lung cancer, because overall survival in lung cancer patients, only 10%. Here is much more. You see now incidence depending on location in breast, most frequent in upper outside quadrant, practically half of disease, and then only central, upper inside, then upper outside, and maybe smallest number in lower inside. What do we do in case of breast cancer? We use surgery, radiation therapy, target therapy, hormonal treatment, chemotherapy. What about surgery? Surgery for breast cancer may be or lumpectomy or mastectomy. Lymph node surgery also may be sentinel node biopsy or axillary lymph node dissection separately or simultaneously with mastectomy. And after all of this, if patient wants, we use breast reconstruction surgery. Lumpectomy. Very widespread. We use principles of breast conserving surgery or partial segmented mastectomy with special all in all times irradiation of the breast after it. Surgically removing the tumor and a small margin of healthy tissues around. And usually we control line of the incision, because if we find cancer cells on the line of the incision, we use re-incision and then re-control of these lines until clear borders. And all of this followed by radiation therapy, I told you. Mastectomy. Simple mastectomy. This is removing the lobes, ducts, fatty tissues, nipple, areola, and some skin of all the breast. Radical mastectomy by Madden. This is simple mastectomy combined with the removal of the intermuscular fat between major and minor pectoralis muscles and axillary lymph nodes, axillary, subscapular, subclavicular, always. Radical mastectomy by Patty Dyson. Also the same, but additionally we remove minor pectoralis muscle. Radical mastectomy by Holstead, we remove both muscles and all which I told you before. Here is radical mastectomy by Madden. You see, this is removal of all the breast, and regional lymph nodes, axillary, subscapular, subclavicular. This is a view after radical mastectomy, scar after radical mastectomy. Lymph node surgery. There are normally from 10 till even 40 normal lymph nodes maybe in males and females. It may be done with mastectomy simultaneously or separately, or even separately and or simultaneously with breast conserving surgery. This is separate question of breast surgery, lymph node surgery. Sentinel lymph node biopsy, I told you, we use it to determine if cancer is spread to the guard lymph node, first of all. And on the base of this affection, we can tell, are they affected or not in other lymph nodes in axillary subscapular region. And on the base of this sentinel lymph node biopsy, if it is positive or we found metastasis in the sentinel lymph node, as a rule, we do biopsy. In case of negative answer, no metastasis in sentinel lymph nodes, we don't do biopsy. But what's underwater stone here? In 20% of cases, maybe avoiding of guard lymph nodes, or by another words, maybe metastasis to the axillary lymph node without metastasis to the guard lymph node, avoiding metastasis directly to the axillary without metastasis to the sentinel lymph node. And you need to remember about this situation. And on the base of CT, are they growing or some or in other signs, you need to understand maybe affection of axillary lymph nodes without this. And you need to do axillary lymph node dissection without even affection of guard lymph node or sentinel lymph node. Here is schematical picture. How do we do this sentinel lymph node biopsy? On the upper picture, here is injection of dye. Here is colored lymph node we remove, sentinel lymph node. After all of surgery, we do usually, if patient wants, we do reconstructive breast surgery. What aim of this recreating of breast so that it looks as much as possible and like the other breast. And usually, also, we use surgery of another breast because usually we need to decrease it or to lift it up. Surgeon may use a breast implant or tissue from another part of the patient's body. A lot of special operations. Radiation therapy for breast cancer. We use X-ray or particles to kill cancer cells. Sometimes the patient require 3 to 5 sessions per week. Usually we use 5. Type of breast cancer will determine the type of radiation therapy, of course. Breast radiation therapy we use after lumpectomy or breast conserving surgery. Chest wall radiation therapy we used after mastectomy, especially of T4 forms with neoadjuvant treatment. And breast boost, this is a high dose of radiation therapy, is applied to where the tumor was surgically removed for local surgery. Lymph nodes radiation therapy in case of affection of lymph nodes aimed first of all to the axillary or supraclavicular regions. to destroy cancer cells in this region and for local control of this region. Brachytherapy. This is radiation or to the breast by place of radioactive seeds, we call them seeds, pellets, into the breast tissue. Usually, this is a device which we put into the space left from breast conserving surgery. A source of radiation in this place there and for a short time, and then we remove it after radiation. Chemotherapy. Chemotherapy, of course, also used for killing of cancer cells. Usually we do it intravenously, but we can give it as a pills or tablets through bloodstream or peros, combats with metastasis in adjuvant regimen or in neoadjuvant regimen may also be. But of course, for chemotherapy, we damage normal cells also. This is one of chemotherapeutic agents, capecitabine. Also, I told you chemotherapy we use before surgery, neoadjuvant regimen, and after surgery, adjuvant regimen. It's given in cycles. Of course, between cycles, 2 up to 3 weeks for repairing of bone marrow cells. Early stage, we use up to 8 cycles, which takes 3 to 6 months. For late stage, for advanced breast cancer, we often continue as long as it possible. What side effects? Short, first of all, short-term side effects, hair loss. You saw a lot of patients after chemotherapy, loss of appetites, nausea, vomiting, high risk of infection due to depression of immunity, stopping of menstrual period, easy bruising or bleeding, and being very tight, long-term menstrual changes, nerve damage, and heart damage. Hormonal therapy of breast cancer. First of all, we use it for only receptor-positive patients, for ER-positive, PR-positive patients. First of all, for ER, because all therapy is directed to ER receptors. And you know that estrogen and progesterone promotes cancer growth. First, type of these medicines, which are block the these receptors. They block receptors of estrogen, and estrogen cannot bind with its receptor due to block by medicines. That's why due to this block, this loss of stimulation by estrogens, by blocking of receptors on the surface of the tumor cells. What most bright examples of medicines? Tamoxifen, toramifen, fariston, and fulvestrant. These are most famous. Another type of drug therapy, we use it for patients in menopause. I forgot to tell you, first of all, for hormone-positive patients, we need to see what's level of hormones in this woman. If woman before menopause, level of hormones is very high. How to decrease, first of all, these levels of hormones? We need to give them or special inhibitors. We call them luteinizing hormone, releasing hormone inhibitors. For example, Zoladex, or to remove ovaries. After injections of special inhibitors or after ovariectomy, or patients in menopause, they all in menopause after this. And then we treat patients, women in menopause. Here is level of hormones is lower, and here we can use, first of all, antiestrogens, inhibitor of receptors. I told you before, And now, drugs used to change hormone levels. First of all, aromatase inhibitors. In fat tissue, in females, in males, from testosterone, under the action of special enzyme aromatase, is making estrogen. We can block this production by aromatase inhibitor medicines. For example, Femara. And I told you about luteinizing hormone, releasing hormone analogs, which shut down the ovaries, how it's written here. It's Zoladex. But Zoladex is not treatment, is not hormonal treatment. It's only stop of ovaries in young women for a special time. There are two modifications of this. During 1 month injection and during 3 months. After these 3 months, ovaries are repairing and no menstrual function is normal in this woman. That's why they need always to inject every 3 months to inject this medicine. And simultaneously with this medicine to use or antiestrogens, blockers of receptors or inhibitors of aromatase. This is hormonal treatment. And last one, targeted therapy for breast cancer, HER2-new positive patients. I told you before that HER2-new patients, this is separate group with very high aggressive form of breast cancer, but it is sensitive to special treatment, for targeted therapy. And first of all, for inhibitors of this HER2-new. First of all, this is trastuzumab, most famous Herceptin. Pertuzumab Perjeta, other trastuzumab emtanzin Kadcyla, and last one lapatinib Tecarb. This is all information about breast cancer which I wanted to tell you today. Thank you for your attention, and lecture is over. Thank you very much.